The client totally agreed and seemed equally excited. We were all keen to move forward to what would have really mattered, making some actual ads, when the marketing director said, "Of course, we'll have to know what the creative idea is first." We looked blankly. Unconsciously channeling David Ogilvy, I said, "That line is the creative idea." The clients looked at me pityingly. "No, that's just a line. We need to know what the idea is behind it before we can approve any further work." I need hardly tell you that we spent the next 18 months in sterile arguments about the answer to this unanswerable question, until we had lost any enthusiasm for the campaign and almost lost the will to live. Not only did they want to dig behind the text to find a subtext which is the true one, they wanted to do this for a text that hadn't even been written yet. In 2007, Cadbury produced a striking commercial which attracted much public attention. It showed a man in a gorilla suit sitting at the drums, playing loudly and angrily along to the Phil Collins song, "In the Air Tonight." It was the early days of YouTube, and many people were sharing it online and arguing about what it meant and why they found it so compelling. History is not clear as to whether this ad sold a lot of chocolate or not. There are conflicting accounts that do the rounds, though I am inclined to think that, as the ad was famous, popular, voted the nation's favourite ad, and clearly identified with the Cadbury brand through a subtle use of colour as a distinctive asset, it very probably did. The interesting thing, though, is what Cadbury did next. The marketing director, Phil Rumble, had obviously gone to hell and back to sell this mystifying ad to the Cadbury management.